In this video, I am going to explain how to enter transactions in journal. In a previous video, I have already explained how to enter transactions in a journal with a receipt problem. Six problems I had brought in that exercise, that all problems are of receipt. In this problem also, I have brought some exercises or some transactions with the same receipt transactions. Here, then after learning about a receipt transactions, and then I will try to explain about payment, and I will bring some two problems on payment, and then I will bring some problems on contra. Before entering the transactions in a journal, first I wanted to repeat what processing steps we need to follow to solve these transactions to enter in a journal. First step is, in every transaction there will be two accounts. First we need to try to find out what are the two accounts this transaction is affecting. Means we need to search for the accounts on which accounts this transaction is affecting. Because we follow double entry system of accounting, so in every transaction there will be two accounts. Okay, first step is to search the accounts on which accounts this transaction is affecting. Next we need to find out these accounts are following which type of golden rule. And next, we need to find out whether that account is a credit and debit depending on the golden rules. Okay, these are the three steps we need to follow. Here, this is the first problem which I have taken in my exercise. First one is, I will read now. Rohan traders started business with rupee 1 lakh. Means Rohan is a person. He has started one business, that is the Rohan traders. This business has started business with a 1 lakh rupee. Okay. In this, two accounts will come. First one is what? Cash account. Because this business they have started with a cash of 1 lakh rupee. So first one what will come? Cash account will come. And whatever amount they have invested for the business, that is called as a capital account. Okay. But after end of the financial year, or else whenever this company will be shut down, that time this amount has to be returned back to the shareholders or else for the owner. So this capital account will come under liability in the balance sheet. So two accounts we have already found out in this problem. So first one is what here? Cash account I will consider. Cash account is also called as a assets, building, land and furnitures and goods and services. These all are come under real account. So this cash account will come under what? Real account. Okay. Next one is capital account. Capital account is what? Personal account. Capital account is considered as a personal account because this capital account is brought from the investors or else owner. So whoever is going to invest in the business, that will be come under personal account. So who is the giver here? Owner. It might be a shareholders. So this capital account will come under personal account. The here is what? Personal account. Okay. Next one is, here I have written, here I will write personal account, and next one is what? Real account. Okay. Here both accounts I have written, personal and real accounts. Here personal account is coming under capital account. This capital account I am going to, means whether this capital account will come under credit and debit. First I will check this here by looking at this table. Personal account, giver, capital is given by the owner or else investors. So who is the giver? Giver will come under credit here. Capital account will come under credit here. Next one is what? Real account. Real account is what comes in for the business. Cash is coming for the business. So cash account will come under debit here. I hope you are understanding. Received cash to syndicate bank RS 50,000 from Gajanana for selling goods. For selling goods means this is related to a business. So what two accounts are coming here? First one is, in a previous problem, cash we had took, but this amount is receiving to syndicate bank. So one account will come as a syndicate bank account. Next one is, from whom we are receiving? Gajanan. We are receiving from Gajanan. Next one is what? Gajanan account. Okay, now we have already find out two accounts here. So now we will try to find out these two accounts will come under which golden rule. So syndicate bank is what? Bank account. Person names and bank names will come under personal account. I will write next one. Gajanan is also one person, so it will come under personal account. So this is also what? Personal account. So we will write here personal, both are personal account. This is also personal account. Come as a bank account is receiving 50,000 amount. So who is the receiver here? Syndicate bank is receiver. So syndicate bank is receiver. So syndicate bank should come under debit aspect. Next one is, and who is giving? Gajanan is paying to the syndicate bank. So who is the giver here? Gajanan. Next problem is what here? Shreya pays Rs 20,000 cash. Shreya is paying Rs 20,000 cash to the organization, but they have not given to whom she is paying. So, but we need to assume this company has been started by Rohan. So this company name is what? Rohan Traders. This Shreya is a second party. So Shreya is paying means she might be paying to the Rohan Traders company itself. So Shreya is a second party. So one account will come as a Shreya here. Shreya account. And next account is what? Cash account. Okay. Shreya is a person name. So this account will come under personal account. Next one, cash account is what? Cash, assets, building, land, goods, these all will come under real account. Okay. Next, after finding this much, we need to think this account will come under debit or credit aspects. Next one, I will write personal account here. Next one is what? Real account. Next one is personal account is what here? Shreya account. Shreya account, already we have understood this is the personal account. Who is the giver here? Shreya is paying to whom owner it is. So Shreya is the second party. So she is the giver. So Shreya account will come under what? She is the giver. So she will come under credit aspect. Next one is real account. What is received by the company? Cash is received by the company. So what comes in for the business? Cash will come for the business. So cash account is what? Cash account is what? Debit account. Next one. Rent received from godown of 10,000. So one more thing we need to think here. Rent received from godown. Rent, what business is receiving? Rent business is received by, rent is received by the business here. So here what I will write? Rent account. What business is receiving? Business is receiving cash here. So next one is what? Cash account. No, so next one is what? Rent account. Rent is receiving. Receiving means it is a income for the business. So receiving will come under nominal account. All incomes and gains come under nominal account. So this rent is nominal account. So otherwise you can write rent receiving account. Otherwise if anyone other account rent paid like that come, then you will be confused. So while taking accounts, you need to be very careful what name you need to give for that lectures. Now it is a nominal account. Next one is cash account. Already we have understood it will come under real account. Next one is, now we will think on which specific golden rule it will come. Next one is what here? These types of account is what here? nominal. Next one is real. Nominal C. What is there for in a nominal account? Rent receiving account. So all gains, it is a gain for the business. So it will come under what? It is gain for the business. So all incomes and gains, rent is coming for the business. So it will come under credit account. Rent receiving account. Next one is real account. Cash account already we have understood. What is coming for the business? Cash is coming for the business. So it will come under debit account. I hope you all understood how to enter these transactions in a journal. So if you understood this, it will be very easy for you to enter in a vouchers. Thank you so much for watching my video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel.